track review.
Hey everyone, Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd here, doing a really quick raw track review of the new Clipping song, Something They Don't Know, which features a league of from Senor Benedict the Moor, as well as two Hellfire Club members, Nocando and Open Mike Eagle. If you don't know Clipping, they're an experimental West Coast hip-hop trio. I've loved their past two records. I will link to those albums down in the description box, reviews to those albums rather, so you can just sort of see my feelings on their music thus far. And then building off of that, they have recently come out with a single called Knees on the Ground, which is actually a reflection, an opinion, a point of view on everything that's been going down in Ferguson, Missouri lately. And it's one of the best hip-hop singles I've heard this year. It's one of the best singles I think Clipping have put out thus far. It's one of their best songs lyrically. It's one of their most chilling songs instrumentally. So do not leave this track review. Do not leave this track without at least trying that song as well. Clipping, Knees on the Ground, linked in the description. All right, but as far as this new track goes, it's just kind of a posse cut, creating a linkage between Clipping, SB, and Hellfire Club. Three acts in underground hip hop right now that I'm glad are coming together to make some noise, because I think, you know, coming together, more strength, I suppose. And even though a collaboration like this could have gone terribly, I think in this case, it actually goes extraordinarily well. We get four verses on this thing, four grimy verses. We have a fantastic instrumental, which has just some punchy kicks, some really propulsive hi-hats, sort of like ticker tape. We have a broken piano sample, some sort of rootsy acoustic guitar, slide guitar samples on this track as well, but the instrumental takes on a slightly different flavor with each verse. We have some weird drones in the background of some parts. We have a strange Old Dirty Bastard sample where you're getting the vocal sample of him being like, oh hey, remember when we used to do this when we were kids? If you remember Old Dirty Bastard's first full-length album, you remember that part of his record because of how long and how strange it is on that album. And this part is directly sampled as Basek Brink, who has appeared on Clipping's previous material. He brings some DJ cuts to the table over this sample, and it's absolutely nuts. So the instrumental, really dynamic, just really changes like a chameleon with each rapper on top of it. And then we have the rap verses themselves, all of which have different stories and I guess sort of tones and personalities to them. It's not like it's a concept track or a cohesive track or anything like that. It's just four spitters bringing some great bars. David's verse is fantastic. Like usual, has a story, has a theme, has a concept. It kind of has this amazing nursery rhyme reference, Sally sells seashells by the seashore, but instead he has this woman who might be this lady of the night selling Cialis out of her apartment. And this old guy comes in who might be not only buying this Cialis, but also having sex with her. I guess he tries to pull something, she knifes him and ices him, and that's pretty much the story. David, he has violent stories in his verses, like much hip-hop music, but the stories that he often tells kind of feel like there's something more out of like a Sin City, you know, graphic novel, or like a Tarantino movie or something like that. And this verse, I think, is, you know, a fantastic verse from him. So, you know, I was definitely pleased with that. SB the Moor, I think this dude is really finding his voice, and he's getting real close to it on this track. His flow is fantastic on this song. I remember when I was first blogging and tweeting about this guy, a lot of people were like, this dude sounds like Danny Brown. And he doesn't quite sound like Danny on this track. He's definitely progressing into his own, and he's got a lot of technical skill. And I like the I see it, you know, sort of alliteration or rhyme scheme pattern that he does in his verse. He's just got a lot of technical skill. I think he's finding his voice. Nocando's verse is pretty decent, not one of his best verses, though I do continue to love his voice and love his flow. And then Open Mike Eagle, I think, has a series of just funny rhymes, funny inflections and expressions and lyrical references. He takes a psychedelic gummy bear. He's also got, let me see what I've written down. He has this funny reference where he talks about his rap cassettes being busted, but he won't throw them away. He says, hey, how much does that actress make to be on The Bachelorette? He says, human beings are just bags of bones. He also says that you can, you know, grind down apple seeds to make poison. Just a lot of funny references and, you know, I guess just expressions in Open Mike Eagle's verse. I guess my only issue with that, I guess, is it's a long song, and it just kind of sucks that he was stuffed right at the end after the DJ cuts, you know what I mean? But I guess in a way they did kind of save the one of the best verses at least for last. So yeah, I thought this was a great track. I think Clipping are still doing a fantastic job of making experimental hip-hop that has such a clear link to hip-hop. You know, they're just doing so many different things, they're venturing out in so many different ways, but their music is very clearly, unequivocally hip-hop. And I think that's all I can say about this track. Transition, if you've given this song a listen, what did you think of it? Did you love it, hate it, why? What do you think I should review next? And that's it. I hope you have a nice day. Anthony Fantano, Track Reviews.